What's up, sons? It's Blind Run, and I am here to bring to you the newly released RX 460. This one is from Asus and is the Strix trim of the card. It's packed with a whole bunch of features I've never really seen under the $200 price point. Hell, this card's under $150, and it comes with a custom cooler design, RGB lighting, and a fan header? Awesome. Stick around. The Asus Strix RX 460 features Wingblade 0 dB fan designs with visually intrusive heat pipes emerging from beneath the shroud. The RGB is limited, to say the least, only gracing the logo design at the top of the card. But for the low price point, these features are still impressive. There is also an additional fan header for more system fan control, which is a nice touch for compact systems, which I assume you would be putting this card in, or at least targeting this card towards. Display adapters include one display port, a single HDMI 2.0 port, and a single DVI. The only AMD card in the 400 series to include one. At this price point, 1080p 60Hz panels often come with DVI as the only option, so it's nice to see this here. Next, we have a 6-pin power adapter sporting a standard 4+1 power phase, drawing a total of 75 watts TDP. Under the hood, the card sports a 1234 MHz boost clock, which we were able to overclock to 1299 MHz. The boost clock communicates over a 120-bit bus with 4 GB of GDDR5 at a 7000 MHz effective clock, which we were able to overclock to 7200 MHz. Even with the overclock enabled, the card stayed cool, never surpassing 63 degrees Celsius with stock fan profiles. However, if you do decide to crank the fans to 100%, they stay quiet, only rising 15 decibels over ambient room noise. All games were benchmarked in 1080p at highest available settings, unless those settings are proprietary to a particular board maker, such as Purehair, unless I have stated otherwise. In Rise of the Tomb Raider, the Asus Strix RX 460 hit 17.86 frames per second. However, turning some settings down to medium does provide a playable experience. Forza Motorsport 6 Apex Beta performed extremely well with a very smooth and constant 45.2 frames per second. Super impressive for this little guy. In TimeSpy Graphics Test 1, the RX 460 hit 20.3 frames per second, and in TimeSpy Graphics Test 2, it scored 16.26 frames per second. Doom performed amazingly in ultra settings at a buttery smooth 73.9 frames per second, which is more of a testament to the developers over there than to maybe the RX 460 itself. The Talos Principle was not playable at 31.9 frames per second, but becomes playable at lower settings. Gears of War Ultimate Edition scored a playable 51 frames per second, even with 4K textures, and easily stays above 60 if you turn 4K textures off. Hitman would not boot. I tried everything I could and it refused to get past the loading screen, even after a fresh install of Windows and in both DirectX 12 or DirectX 11. Total War Warhammer must be getting some optimization updates as the RX 460 hit 39.5 frames per second, beating out my previous test for both the RX 470 and the RX 480, and some further testing NVIDIA cards are now performing worse than before. I included this benchmark as more of a PSA for the game development than for comparison's sake. For a little fun, I tested the latest and greatest currently out from Hello Games, the famous or infamous No Man's Sky, in their experimental beta. It was playable, however, hitching was present, with a min of 33, max of 50, and average of 39.5 frames per second at medium settings in 1080p. There is a price point that I never recommend going below. While this is a great budget card, it still falls below that line. If you are on a a ridiculously tight budget, the RX 460 will get the job done most of the time. However, it hits walls in some games. There are frankly some games that you won't even be able to run. For an additional $40, you can jump up into the RX 470, which is a night and day comparison when you consider performance and compatibility to the RX 460. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe down below. And remember, I'm Son of a Tech, and I will see you next Tuesday.